It's nice and early on a Saturday, and it's supposed to be raining, so sit back, relax, and soak this one in, because I'm really excited to bring you this episode of Why I Want, this time focusing again on second round talents for the Vancouver Canucks and why I would want them for my favorite team. In this video, we're taking a look at Patrik Puistola. Now, a lot of you guys might be thinking, okay, let's get this one going. Who's Patrik Puistola and why do you want him, Lego? Well, I'll tell you who he is. Patrik Puistola is a left wing player eligible for the 2019 NHL entry draft. He was born in January 2001, so he's 18 years old. He's 6'0", 174 pounds. So that's the kind of player he is. He's got a pretty okay frame, he's a left winger, and he's a guy who can be drafted. Now, Puistola is a draft eligible this year, and he's projected to go around the 40s. Future Considerations has him at 42, Elite Prospects, they have him at 41, and the Vancouver Canucks are picking at 40. So with this being established, let's go over what exactly it is I like about Puistola and go further in depth, because there are a lot of great things to talk about when it comes to his game. He's playing in the Finnish league right now, but his year was actually quite crazy. He spent the majority of his time split between three Finnish leagues. He started out his season with the Junior ASM Liiga, that is the under-20 league in Finland. He was playing for Tappara's U20 team. He had 22 points in 25 games played, which is pretty good for a then 17-year-old playing against U20 competition, but he was really, really good. So good, in fact, that he was loaned over to the Métis and played for the Lecce team for 22 games this season. In the Métis, he got himself 26 points, and that sounds pretty good. I'll let you know in a little bit why that's actually really good, but he actually spent some time in the Liga as well, 16 games with the full-on Tappara team as a 17-18-year-old. He had one assist in those 16 games, so really, the bulk of his draft stock came from his performances in the U20 League and in the Métis. Playing for Finland's U18 team, he got 5 goals in 5 games at the under-18s, which was really good for him, and against all U18 competition for Team Finland, 22 points in 21 total games played, 14 goals too. So now that we've gotten the stats out of the way, I wanted to talk a little bit about what makes Puistola's draft year so special. And pretty much it comes down to one thing. It's the fact that he was so good playing in the Métis this year. He was over a point per game in the Métis as a U18 player. And some of you might be thinking, okay, that sounds all right. What exactly makes that so special? Well, it's the fact that the Métis is basically the second tier pro league in Finland. To put things into perspective, Elias Pettersson, he's a guy that I'll probably mention a few times in this commentary, Pettersson was drafted out of the Allsvenskan, and the Allsvenskan is not as good as the SHL in Sweden. Allsvenskan level hockey is second tier. It is the tier below the number one pro league, which is the SHL. It's the same thing as the relationship between the Liga and the Métis. The Liga is tier 1, the Métis is tier 2. But that doesn't discredit the fact that the Métis is still a pro league, and it does involve players of all ages playing at a number one professional standard. Which is why Puistola, having the production that he did, was really good. If you go over into the all-time totals for the Métis, Puistola is literally the best U18 player that has ever stepped into that league. His points per game is better than any U18 player that has ever stepped into that league, including guys like Marcus Granlund, Mikael Granlund, Jesse Puljujärvi. Now, obviously, you have to take into consideration that some of these guys, their draft years were the year after they played in the Métis, but in the case of Marcus Granlund, for example, he's a guy who played his draft year and spent some time in the Métis. Puistola has a higher points per game than him. With this point being established, I wanted to turn your attention to what Cam Robinson, I believe, said on Canucks Central on their little prospect show that they have over there. Puistola doesn't have an NHL comparable, and it's because he played in a league and he was so good, so highly above everybody else who's ever played in that league. It's almost like an Elias Pettersson situation. Because Pettersson, when he played in the Allsvenskan, he was amazing, he was a total beast, he was a huge footnote in U18 players to have played in the Allsvenskan in their draft years. And he was so good that he didn't have a comparable, because he just had so many points. The same can be said about Pistola. The context is almost the same. They're playing their draft years in the second tier of hockey in their country, and they're so good that there's no historical comparison in the history of those leagues. But the comparisons won't really stop there. Because if you take a look at what Pistola does on the ice, and I'm being completely serious when I say this, go over there and watch the tape, watch his play. He looks like Elias Pettersson in the offensive zone. I hate that I'm saying that. It sucks that I'm saying that, because I don't want to put Elias Pettersson comparables to anybody. But the way Pistola plays, it reminds me so much of what Pettersson was able to do, watching him for 2 years now with the Vekwa Lakers and the Vancouver Canucks. The way he plays the game offensively reminds me like Vancouver's Golden Swede. And just with that, you can kind of understand why Pistola was able to get so many points and why he's a class above every U18 player that has ever played in the Métis before. He's got everything that an offensive dynamo could want. He's explosive, he's quick, he's deceptive, he's got a fantastic shot, and his passing ability is really great too. Add to that the amazingly shifty mitts, the confidence, and the playmaking, deking ability. He's really, really good. And he only had 1 point in the 16 Liga games that he played. I get that. But he was playing on Tapera, and Tapera is kind of good. So he was playing with sheltered minutes, you know, he was the guy that shouldn't have gotten a whole bunch of points because he's playing down in the lineup, and he was just promoted from organization, from the U20 Tapera team to Dalecki in the Métis, and then finally the Liga at the very end. But Pistola certainly is a guy who intrigues me. And the fact that he's projected to go 41, 42, 43, it really puts a smile on my face seeing that, because he will most likely be available at 40. That is, assuming that no team before Vancouver sees the potential in Pistola and decides to take a marker on him. But hey, that's why I'm making several Y1s on second round talents, right? But Pistola is probably the guy that I would want the most in the second round, aside from maybe Caden Korsak. So he's a guy that I really see faith in. And he's got to work on his defensive ability, and his skating could use a little bit of work too. He's not the fastest guy out there, but he is above average for sure. But I will give props to his shiftiness and his edges, because he does do a good job at maneuvering around the offensive zone in a very Elias Pettersson-like kind of way. Even when he scores those goals in tight, he very frequently dangles around the goalies and then he shoots and scores and then he falls down, very similar to like how Elias Pettersson does. And I'm serious, guys, watch the tape, go look at what he's able to do out there, check out some Patrik Puistola highlights, because he looks like Pettersson in the offensive zone. And if this guy, who wasn't able to produce at the highest tier of hockey in Finland, but was able to do it at a great level at the second tier, is available at 40, I would love it if the Vancouver Canucks took him. We're not afraid to take Lecky Métis players who are U18. We did it last year with Toni Uuttunen, who was playing on the exact same team. And now Uuttunen, despite not getting a lot of points in the Liga this season, has still shown a lot of promise. So that's exactly why I would like to see Patrik Puistola added to the Vancouver Canucks depth chart. Toni Uuttunen, by the way, he's actually a guy who did play for the Tapera this season in the Liga, so he did get some games played with Pistola. So he's literally a teammate. They both went through the same junior ranks. They went through the same second-tier pro league team in Finland, and they're both playing professionally, and next year it looks like Pistola is gonna go over to Tapera again. So if he's given a bigger role, and he's given middle six, maybe even top six time, he's going to be able to show off his talent to the best of his ability, because so far, he's only seen the bottom of the ice, which is kind of understandable. I mean, the Tapera did rotate a whole bunch of players this season. They had 33 different skaters skate up for their games, which is really, really nuts. So I think that just goes to show just the diversity and the amount of roster depth that the Tapara has, so it doesn't really surprise me that Pistola wasn't able to put it together at the pro level and get a whole bunch of points as much as he did in the second tier, but in the second tier, he was phenomenal, which ultimately is why I would like to get him at 40th overall. Not to mention that Pistola is a player who, if he pans out, if everything goes right and everything translates, the things about him in the Métis go over into the Liga and that success translates into the NHL, then we have ourselves a top six, potentially elite player that we're looking at. And this is a player who, in my opinion, if he does pan out, he could be the first line solution to our Pettersson and Besser line. Just looking at the way that Pistola plays, imagine having two Petterssons playing with Besser. Now, I'm not saying that the ceiling is anywhere near Elias Pettersson, but I am saying that the way that they play is so similar, and Pistola's comparable in terms of U18 production is quite similar to Pettersson's, just in terms of the historical context of their leagues, that it makes sense to me. It really does. Hope you enjoyed this video. Social Dash Rosa saying gaming, and bye.